My name is Ian O'Donnell, and I spent most of the summer of 2021 driving all over the country in a minivan camper, and I stayed at a lot of Walmart parking lots along the way. And I had done some research beforehand, but I learned a whole lot on the fly and this and that. It's all stuff that I wish I could have just known everything right from the beginning before I went out my first time. And that's what I'm trying to do with this video. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into things. I guess the first thing that people want to know about sleeping in a Walmart parking lot is whether or not it's safe. And the answer is it's yes, it is safe if you do it the right way. The first thing I would recommend doing is taking your smartphone and going ahead and downloading this app called RV Parky. There's no sponsorship here whatsoever. It's just a really useful app. So RV Parky has some other great features, such as letting you find rest areas to stay at and Cracker Barrels and blah blah blah, but it's really mostly got Walmarts just like all over it. What's really nice about this is you can Google the town you're going to or the town you're in or wherever, and then find a Walmart that you might want to stay at. And if you click on the Walmart, it'll pop up and it'll give you like a rated review with stars. So I wouldn't stay anything less than 3.5 stars out of the 5. And then furthermore, you can, once you've selected it, you can scroll down and read people's individual comments and see what they say about the place. Oftentimes they'll mention if it's safe or maybe the best place to park when you're there or whatever, or little tips and tricks about the area. It's just really, really helpful information. Especially if you're kind of driving on the fly, because one of the nice things about living in a van is you can just drive without a plan, like you don't know where you're going to stay that night, and then just that night you can find a place really quickly, and you know, this app and others are really helpful for that. So that's the main thing. Once you've read up on that, you should be good to go as far as knowing whether or not it's safe. Another thing you can do if you can't find a whole bunch of reviews on RV Parky or whatever is you can just go straight to Google and Google how safe the town is that you're planning on staying in. The way I always would do it is I would say, you know, is such and such town safe? And that's just the way I would Google it, and then it will pop up and give you like crime rates and this and that, and it will usually just say, oh, this place is moderately safe, or this place is known for a lot of crime or whatever. So you can also use that to kind of gauge how safe the town you're in overall is. And then finally, as far as finding out whether or not the parking lot is safe, is just look around, you know? You can kind of use your gut. See if there's a whole bunch of litter, if there's people kind of loitering around, if it just looks sketchy, if it's really dark, maybe there's not great lighting or whatever. But just look around and see what you can find in that respect. Usually Walmart parking lots are really well lit and there's security cameras everywhere, and it's pretty safe overall. And that kind of brings us to the next thing, is where to park. So this also has to do with safety, but also just in general, you know, where should you park in the parking lot? These are really big parking lots. So especially when you're out west around national parks or where a bunch of people are traveling next to like I-40 or 20 or 10 or whatever, there's going to be a ton of other people out there in RVs and in camper vans and whatnot, staying the night in Walmart parking lots. So when you first pull into a parking lot, you'll usually notice kind of on the far, like further away from the building, you'll see a bunch of RVs and camper vans and such, and they'll just be parking there for the night. So one of your options is obviously you can go park next to all the other camper vans, you know, it'll be nice and safe and that's where everyone else is, and it's just a logical place to park. But there's some other options that I think it's good to know about. I was in a minivan, and from the outside it just looks like a minivan, so I was able to kind of stealth camp a little bit, and I use it to my advantage a lot. At Walmarts, I would park closer to the building, and I would park with the third shift cars. So third shift almost always at every Walmart across the country will park in front of the grocery side. They'll go in and out of that door for like breaks and stuff to go out to their cars or whatever. So if you park a little ways in front of the grocery entrance, you'll be able to kind of blend in with the other vehicles that are going to be there all night for sure. So if you want to go the stealth camping route, that's kind of the spot you want to be rather than out with all the other RV campers and such. Another tip for where to park is I prefer to park directly under the lights, because no one's gonna break into a car that's directly under the lights. Some people aren't a big fan of this because they're like, oh, but then it's too bright or something and you can't sleep, but you should be blacking your windows out anyways. So I think just keep that in mind, if maybe if you're still building out your van, if you're able to completely black out your windows, then it doesn't matter if you're directly under a light, and it's just a safer place to be in general. And also look for the cameras too. There's going to be cameras all over the parking lot, but the closer you are to the building, the more cameras and the more lights you're going to have on you. That's another reason why I preferred to park with the third shift vehicles. But downsides to the third shift vehicles, it's a bit noisier up there versus parking out with the RVs and other camper vans. So, you know, maybe you can try both, or if you're in an RV or if you're in just something that's obviously a camper van, you're probably going to have to camp further out in the parking lot with the other campers, but just some things to consider. A few other quick tips on places to park. I like to park next to those little islands because they have trees in them and bushes sometimes, and no one else is going to be parking on that side of your car, at least. So it's just a more pleasant experience, I've noticed. Also, try to stay away from the buggy deposits because people are going to be, you know, parking buggies there, and you know, one might hit your car, or a worker is going to come by to move buggies and it's going to be really loud. So if you can stay away from those, I would recommend doing it. And then the last thing is at some point you're going to end up staying in a Walmart parking lot that's kind of on a hill, that's just not level. And if you have to do that, ideally you want to be facing where your feet are kind of downhill. It's just more comfortable that way. But also don't be afraid to just park in a weird spot if you have to find something level. Sometimes I would park and sit there for a little bit and be like, this isn't comfortable, and I would drive somewhere else and find something more level. So just a few other things to consider when you're parking, but that's most of what you need to know. The next thing is Wi-Fi. There's actually Wi-Fi at Walmarts, and it's pretty darn good Wi-Fi. It's all Walmarts are kind of on the, I don't think it's necessarily the same network, but once you've logged in once, you're just gonna automatically log in at all the other Walmarts. And the Wi-Fi is 5G Wi-Fi, so it's like really fast. I was able to upload 15-minute YouTube videos in like a couple minutes. It was crazy. If you want to use the Wi-Fi, you're gonna have to be close to the building. Now, this is another reason why I would kind of stay with the third shift vehicles, because if you're closer to the glass parts of the building, your Wi-Fi signals can kind of get through that a little better. And you're closer to the building if you're hiding with the third shift people. So I could sometimes just get Wi-Fi right there and then be on my computer just in my van, and it was great. Another thing you can do, and this is kind of dependent on the Walmart, but sometimes there'll be a side road that'll go along the side of the building and there'll be some parking spaces there. And if you can do that, that's a great place to park because it's out of the way, it's going to be really quiet over there. And you're right next to the building. Even if it is the cement side of the building, you're going to be able to get the Wi-Fi signal there. So, something to keep in mind. Good Wi-Fi, and it's just readily available, it's free to use, awesome. And if you really need some power while you're using the Wi-Fi, you can sometimes go in and there'll be like a fast food restaurant, it's usually like a McDonald's or a Subway or something, that you can sit over there and maybe plug into the wall. And actually have a place to sit and work on your computer. So there's some other options. So overall, just being aware that there is Wi-Fi is useful. I didn't know until I was well into my trip and I accidentally found out that Walmart had Wi-Fi. Pretty cool. Another thing you need to be aware of if you're going to be staying in Walmart parking lots is you can't stay in every single Walmart parking lot. You can stay in most Walmart parking lots all across the country, but some just don't allow it. Some have had like unusually high crime rates, and they don't allow it for that reason, which you'll probably, you know, have read up on that already on RV Parky. But some of them have city ordinances. Usually if there's a Walmart that's within city limits, they do not allow people to stay in their vehicles just as like a safety thing or whatever. Usually if there is a city ordinance that doesn't allow you to stay at a Walmart parking lot, it won't even show up on RV Parky, but it would like show up on Google Maps, obviously. You can go in and ask a manager or security officer if it's okay for you to stay, but anyways, it's just something to be aware of, that there are some city ordinances and it is good to try and follow those city ordinances and not stay anyways. I will admit that I did one time stay at a place that was within a city ordinance, but it was like in the middle of nowhere and I was like really tired and had a headache, so I guess like if there's an emergency you could stay at one, but generally speaking we don't want to break the rules and make it even harder to live in a van than it already is sometimes. So just something to be aware of. It's good to follow those ordinances. There's usually other options, by the way. An example is in Flagstaff, there's a really nice Walmart, but it has a city ordinance. You can't stay there. So you'll probably pass through Flagstaff at some point on your van journeys and maybe find this Walmart. But just down the road, there's a Cracker Barrel you can stay at instead. So it works itself out. The last thing to know is just kind of what happens at night, because stuff goes down in Walmart parking lots late at night in the early AMs. It's not that bad, but there's going to be some noises you're going to hear that are going to freak you out. First off, they have these sweeping, I don't really know what they look like. I've never gotten a good look at them, although I've heard them many, many, many times. It's some kind of giant, like, road sweeping machine, and it will go up and down each aisle of the parking lot and just sweep crap up. You never know when they're going to go out and sweep. Sometimes it's 11 p.m., which isn't that bad. Other times it could be at 3 a.m. in the morning. You have no clue. It's just going to happen at some point during the night. Anyways, they're really loud, and usually they start like on the far side of the parking lot, and so it doesn't wake you up at first, because in the distance it'll just be like meow, 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 right, and it gets louder and louder until it passes right by your vehicle and it sounds like, you know, the world's ending, and it just freaks you out and wakes you up. Anyways, a very terrifying experience, but just be aware that that's something that's gonna happen. Sometimes it's not an issue, but there are these giant sweeper machines that are gonna go through at night. One guy online called them a pavement Zambodis or something. Anyways, that's a pretty accurate description of what they are. But just be aware that those do exist, and you're probably going to encounter one at some point. Another thing is you're going to hear some workers walking around at night. They'll usually take 15-minute breaks randomly, and a lot of guys will come outside and just sit on the curb up at the front or whatever, and you'll hear people talking, and at first it might freak you out, but it's just workers. Another thing they'll do is they'll be out collecting shopping carts too at night, which can be a little noisy, but usually when you hear something outside of your van, it's not someone trying to murder you, it's just like Walmart workers just doing their thing. A few of the things that are going to be rarer occurrences is occasionally someone's going to drive through the parking lot with like a blaringly loud radio. That's only happened to me a few times, but you know, just so you know, that's going to happen pretty much anywhere. Sleep in a van unless you're out like on public land. And then sometimes there'll be airplanes that are going to fly over, and a lot of times on RV Parky you'll read reviews about that. It'll tell you, oh, by the way, this is next to a airport, and usually it gets very low reviews if that's the case. So sometimes you can stay at a Walmart that has less than 3.5 stars like I said earlier, because sometimes they get low reviews because they're next to something like an airport. So it's perfectly safe, it's just noisy because of airplanes. So there could be some other just random sounds like that that you just need to be aware of. And eventually you get used to it. It just becomes background noise. All of this stuff does. But it's nice to know what these sounds are. Because the first time I heard that pavement Zambodi come by, oh my gosh, scared the crap out of me. I had no clue what was happening. But that's really all you need to know about camping in a Walmart parking lot. A few of the quick tips, I guess. If you are trying to be super stealthy, you really just don't want someone to bother you, if you're parking like with the third shift people or whatever, sometimes it's good to back into a parking lot to try and cover your license plate up. That way they don't just walk by and be like, that's not from this state. You know what I mean? If you have a plate on the front and back, I don't know what to tell you, but something else to think about if you are trying to be sneaky or whatever. Also, as far as the restrooms go, you want to use those in the morning, preferably, and early, because that's when they'll be cleanest. And I think it's better to go to the restrooms in the back of the building. It'll usually be around where, like, the TVs are being sold. That's probably the cleaner, less used bathroom, so a few other things to consider. But overall, just don't be scared about sleeping in a Walmart parking lot. It's perfectly safe, and it's really, really, really convenient, because they're literally everywhere. And it's free, which is fantastic. I plan to do some other videos on kind of like what it costs to live in a van and this and that, but just being able to stay in a van in a Walmart parking lot, it saves you so much money. It's crazy. Otherwise, you'd be spending at least $70 to $100 something to stay in a motel or something, but now it's just free, so all you're paying for is gas and food, and then you can just pretty much go anywhere you want to in the country. It's kind of like a crazy life hack or something once you realize you can just sleep in your car. So anyways, that's all I've got for today. Like I said, I want to do some other videos on some of the costs, some other great apps to use, other places that you can stay, this, that, and a whole bunch of other things. And as you can see, I haven't sold the van yet. I am going to take it for one more trip in mid-January. And then after that, I'm going to try and sell it, and we'll go from there. So thanks, guys, for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.